I'm Foster Meyerson for DCW50, and today I'm talking to Chef Eric Adjepong for the new show, Alex vs. America, on Food Network. So, Chef Eric Adjepong, it's very nice to meet you, sir. If I could just rattle off some of your amazing accolades. Folks at home may know him from season 16 and 17 of Top Chef. You're a Ghanaian-American born and raised in New York, and you've got 3 degrees in Culinary Arts, Culinary Nutrition, and International Public Health Nutrition, worked in a string of Michelin-star restaurants. It's truly an honor to meet you.
Pleasure. The pleasure's mine. Thank you guys for having me. And man, it sounds like you, when you list off those things, I'm like, wait, I'm only 34. I was able to do all that stuff.
Yeah, that's incredible. Actually, you make me feel a little bit underachieved, but seriously, it's an honor. So I really wanted to ask you some very simple questions, because I know you've been working in DC lately as a personal chef, caterer, and public health and nutrition advisor. Am I correct? And so I know some other chefs who've been doing similar, who've transitioned into that space, and I was very interested to know kind of how that's been for you this the past year or two, especially with the pandemic, and then kind of how that transitioned into working with Alex on this incredible show, and then we could finish on like kind of what the show means to you and what it means to be a part of that.
Totally, yeah. I mean, I always kind of fell into the dark hole of food and culinary and wanting and knowing more, and I guess wanting to know more after I learned a little bit more. I knew at a very young age, at least when I started this career in this industry, that having some sort of nutritional background would be separate me from other chefs, but then also from other nutritional professionals as well, as I would have like a culinary kind of understanding around food and things like that. And it's been awesome, man. I've been really able and fortunate to not only have some really great clients here in DC area, but in New York as well. And really just helping folks with their everyday needs, you know, whether it be vegetarian, vegan, paleo, Whole30, what is it, diabetes, any sort of like heart disease. We can definitely tailor a menu, a delicious one. That can fit you and your family's needs. And that's something I really enjoy, other than just actually being in the kitchen and working like that.
Yeah, that's excellent. So it's interesting because you take not just the culinary artist approach, you took the kind of the health and public health aspects of it. And that was like, that was a priority for you and kind of bringing that specifically to people's homes.
1000%. Yeah, I think, you know, good food can taste delicious, and just trying to find different ways to not only like highlight things and techniques that and food that people may kind of like, subconsciously kind of just throw away, you know what I mean? And not necessarily deem as delicious because it's supposed to be healthy, and really just kind of challenge people in their palates. And I think I've been able to do a decent job with that.
Obviously you come from West African background. Is that correct?
Yep.
So into what degree do you think that kind of plays in on like the nutritional aspects? And like, do you find that there's a lot of healthier food from where you're coming from that unique perspective that you can really bring to people?
1000%. I think it's also coming from us living in America. We have a very high in the hog sort of mentality when it comes to food, and protein is pretty much the main kind of thing on our plate, and then it's maybe a starch or, you know. So just kind of having that understanding of like a global palate and a global kind of plate, so to speak, and then trying to just kind of, you know, play my part as much as I can. Obviously, we have a very unique kind of feel and the way we eat here in the West and as Americans, but just trying to educate people and let them know that there's different ways that you can feel satiated and, you know, have a good time eating your food, and it doesn't necessarily need to bog you down the whole time.
I love that. Such a balanced perspective, and so incredible coming from someone like so young. Really?
Yeah, no, I appreciate it, man. I mean, I've been doing this at this point half my life. And I really can't imagine doing anything else or being in another industry. I fell in love with food at a really young age, like 6 or 7.
So I guess then we can jump into like the second half of this, which is the more recently you're now working with Alex Guarnaschelli, Iron Chef Alex Guarnaschelli, on this awesome show with Food Network. So tell me a little bit, how did that come to be? How did you get involved with that from the space you were in to being now on this?
You know, saying yes more than no, I think, and just being available. I did an episode of Chopped with Chef Alex, and we hit it off. It was just like freaking frack with both of us, and just a lot of banter in between scenes. And it was our first time meeting, but we felt like we'd known each other for some time. And to my, I'll be honest, I had no idea about the show. She's obviously been working on it behind the scenes for some time. And little to my knowledge, little did I know that she was looking for a host. This is Chef Alex Guarnaschelli. She's world renowned, but also knows so many people, you know what I mean, that can do this job and this hosting opportunity for her. So it was just really a true honor and privilege. It was a blast working with her on the set. We had a lot of fun. I learned so much as well. Like, she's truly an Iron Chef. Like, she is really, I don't think, a situation cooking wise that she hasn't been in or knows how to flourish in. So it was a no brainer for me to say yes. And I'm just so happy that everything kind of came out. And this is my first hosting gig as well. So I was kind of nervous, but I think I did all right. She definitely helped me guide me through all the way.
I love that you worked with her and then like you maintain that connection. I mean, that's something that so many people, it's like one of the hardest things to teach. And I know because I've recently had many mentors who like really burn that into me. It's like, it's about staying in that connection offline, which is, I guess, the thing I wanted to maybe dig on. Was there more like opportunities for you guys to work together, even just in like personally cooking in the kitchen, hanging out offline, that kind of stood out to you and like in maintaining that relationship?
Yeah, I definitely agree. I think, you know, your knowledge and you know, the things that you know, your skill sets are going to get you up to a certain point, but it's really the connections, the network, the relationship that you have with Foster. In my relationship with Alex, I mean, after the Chopped episode, we did a couple of episodes of Supermarket Stakeout, and just texting back and forth, calling back and forth. So I think just naturally and organically, we were able to really, really start to foster a really, like, really cool relationship. And I think you can see that on TV as well. Just our banter and our, you know, our communication between each other for the rest of the season. I think it's really, really evident.
Thank you for that. That's such a valuable perspective to be able to share with our audiences. So then I guess finally we should talk about kind of like what this show is like and what you hope to be able to offer through the platform of the show to audiences.
I think the show ultimately is just a more kind of raw, uncut feature of competition in culinary space. But ultimately, it's just Alex versus some of the best chefs in America, period. She's going up against chocolatiers, pasta makers, people who are, you know, well-versed in spices, people who know, like, their seafood. It's just, like, top-tier specialists in culinary arts coming up, and they're trying to beat Alex. And she's, like, holding her own insanely. So it's, you know, it's really a different perspective on not only Alex, but America as well. Like, you get to see some of some really great featured chefs and get some really cool stories. And you'll get to realize, like, there's a lot of people, talented chefs all across America that are just killing it in so many different ways.
That's such an excellent concept there, because it's like seeing a master at work, seeing someone who really has achieved the fullness, or at least the closest to it, of their intended goals in life, and to see that tested in like the real crucible of competition. And I really want to dig in on that, because I know the two of you have a fairly similar background in competitive cooking. In addition to that, it can like catch their attention. Is there something about that competition you think can really help people learn something?
Yeah, definitely, man. I think when you're competing, regardless, you're testing yourself and you're kind of seeing your skills set against maybe a group of other people. It's about staying comfortable, staying within your lane, trying not to do anything too crazy, too different, but still, you know, adhering to the challenges that are, you know, that are coming against you. And ultimately, really, it's just a test of your skill and kind of see where you're at. I think with competition, I love competition since I was a little kid, whether it's basketball, football, whatever, racing, I'll do whatever. It is what it is. It's advertised, and I love that about this show and this competition. And we did a really good job. I think we kept integrity there, and we had a lot of fun doing it. And I think the team was well.
That's incredible. Thank you so much. I really do look forward to it. I think you've really sold me on this. So I guess we could just wrap this up. Tell people kind of where they can find the show and how they can engage with it.
For sure. Yes. So Alex versus America is now airing on Food Network. On Sundays, check it out, 10 p.m. We are putting out new episodes every week. And just really just follow along social media, foodnetwork.com, follow Chef Alex himself, and just kind of keep up with everything that we got going on. Amazing guests, amazing chef coming through, amazing judges as well. and it's just a load of fun. It's a competition show. It's intense, but there's a level of kind of like the chill and cool atmosphere about it that I think is really unique to it. So I hope you guys enjoy it. I can't wait for you guys to watch it. And two episodes are out right now. That's streaming on Discovery Plus as well. So yeah, enjoy it, guys.
Thank you so much, Chef Eric Adjepong. It's been an honor.
Take care, guys.
Alex Guarnaschelli is one of the best competition cooks in America.
Michael Jordan plays basketball. Serena Williams plays tennis. Tiger Woods plays golf. I cook. Simple as that. People always want to know what's next. This is it.
It's almost impossible to defeat her one-on-one.
So each week, she'll be battling three of America's best chefs at the same time.
I think I can beat her.
I need my shot at Alex.
The gauntlet has been thrown down.
I know I have a target on my back, and I wouldn't have it any other way.